One of our big reporters, Devin Dwyer, has been covering this, and he's been traveling the country talking to people about these impeachment proceedings and whether what the president did was right or wrong in the public sentiment. Devin, what can you tell us about your conversations with voters all across this country?
Hey, Tom, great to be here. You know, I have to say that support for this impeachment inquiry right now is as high as it's ever been. In fact, Kira and I checked out the 538 impeachment tracker just before we went on today. And take a look at this number. 52% of Americans, according to our friends at 538, actually support the hearings getting underway today, just the fundamental inquiry that will go down over these next few weeks. Different from removing the president, we should say, but a high watermark so far. Democrats also come into this, Kira, with some wind at their back. Majorities say they suspect that the president's behavior when it comes to Ukraine may have been inappropriate, so they really want to learn some facts. But I've got to tell you, Tom alluded to our travel in a number of states, particularly the upper Midwest, places Democrats need to win. There are some flashing caution signs there from voters who are skeptical about what they're going to be seeing over the next few weeks. Here's a flavor of what we heard in Ohio.
Everything should be investigated. If you have the majority in the House to actually pursue the investigation, then you should do it, right?
Well, from what I understand, and I'm not all into all the laws and everything, but from what I understand, that he's allowed to ask foreign people for help.
Do you think that's okay for a president to ask another leader of a country to say, hey, go investigate this guy?
No.
That's my rival?
No. Then that's why, like, I'm half for Trump and half not. Because I don't agree with some of the stuff he does. But at the same time, like I said, there's other things I agree with.
It feels like that if we don't impeach, that it might just become the norm. That things like this happen and they can just be sort of swatted away with partisan politics.
And you heard it there, Kira, at the end from that guy in northern Columbus. He wants accountability. A lot of voters we hear from on both sides of the aisle believe in accountability, but they're distrusting of the source of information, both the media and the politicians on Capitol Hill. And they're also so busy in their normal lives, their day-to-day lives, that they need a compelling reason to come forward to really listen, lean in a little bit more. And so that's the challenge that Democrats have.
So are they going to watch these hearings? And could that be a base motivator? Will there be paying attention to see if there is anything else that could be revealed and change their mind possibly?
Yeah, this is going to be a blockbuster on television today. Every TV channel will carry this, we know. In fact, the bars here in Washington have opened early. There are drink specials. You can get a subpoena colada if you want one this early in the morning. But again, it's this story, as you've been talking about, is so complicated for people out in the middle of the country. They're just trying to get to work, take care of their kids, and hearing about all these figures in Ukraine, a place that I must say most of the people I talked to couldn't point out on a map.
Well, they know now.
They couldn't name the Ukrainian president. They will by the end of these hearings, for sure. But we do expect millions to turn in, and we'll have to see if this is a game changer politically.
All right, Tom, as millions obviously turn in to watch the hearing, my guess is millions will be hitting the subpoena colada special as well. After this is all over, it's going to be a long day, Tom.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.